In Iceland, there is a decent possibility that not one, but two volcanic eruptions could occur in the month of March north of the town of Grindavik, specifically on or around March 4th and March 29th if the current pattern continues. In a worst-case scenario, this could even send lava flows into Grindavik proper or cause an explosive eruption which emits ash from a vent offshore of the peninsula. This is all because the Reykjanes volcano, which some news sites are calling Svartsengi but in reality is considered part of the Reykjanes volcano, seems to be undergoing a fairly predictable 25-day cycle. This cycle is somewhat similar to the periodic eruption of a geyser in a manner of speaking, and is caused by the refilling of a magma chamber at 5 kilometers depth 1100 meters south of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant at a rate of approximately 5 cubic meters per second. Once this magma chamber reaches a volume of between 10 million and 12 million cubic meters, the magma rapidly drains towards the east and then intrudes towards the surface. The longest step, the refilling of the shallow magma chamber, appears to involve three distinct stages of fairly constant but varied uplift rates, which last from approximately day 1 to day 12, day 13 to day 21, and day 22 to day 25. Several scientists have noted a decrease in the rate of uplift in the last few days, which, in my opinion, is due to an expected decrease around day 13 in this approximately 25-day-long pattern. Although I do not personally expect an eruption at this constant rate for the rest of the year, if this was to hypothetically occur, then the Reykjanes volcano might erupt another 13 times before the end of 2024. In terms of Grindavik, the most heavily affected town which has largely been abandoned in the last 4 months, I have some news. All residents are currently allowed back into the town but at their own risk, and I would recommend against going back and except to remove your own valuables. Due to the fact that many people, myself included, expect the eventual complete destruction of Grindavik due to lava flows, the Icelandic government has put in place a program to buy out all residential properties within the town. The figure which would be paid is equal to 95% of a property's fire insurance value, and since many residents paid more than this for their house, it represents a loss of money for many people. In total, Grindavik contains the equivalent of $762.4 million worth of buildings and infrastructure. Approximately $522.3 million of worth is eligible for government buyout. If you own a home in Grindavik and by chance have performed renovations which might have hypothetically increased its value since the house was last assessed, I recommend getting a reassessment before you sell. It is simply unwise and unsafe in my opinion to live in Grindavik at this time. Although magma has currently pooled to around 4.9 million cubic meters in its shallow magma chamber, there has also been a notable rise once again in the number of earthquakes of the offshore Eldey volcano to the west-southwest. Eldey during the past few thousand years has seemingly shown a weak connection to Reykjanes, with eruptions from the two volcanoes sometimes occurring close together in time. Although there does not currently appear to be an imminent threat, GPS sensors were once again placed on its tallest vent above sea level, Eldey Island, to determine if any unusual activity is ongoing. I want to also note that the Reykjanes volcano's hazard zone has been expanded to the southwest due to the risk of subsidence-related ground cracks there. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.